As you are able to, please stand at this time and join us in singing our opening song, Spirit is in this place. Let's make sure that comes up. Spirit is in this place. Here we go. We have come together as family. We have come here as we are. We have come with arms wide open. We have gathered here in love. Sing out now. Sing it nice and loud and clear, come on now. Spirit is in this, Spirit is in this place. Can you feel it in your heart, your soul, your body? Raise the roof with shouts of praise. Spirit is in this place. Nice. And let's do verse 2. And we sing in celebration. We sing with words of prayer. Amen, namaste. We affirm our life as sacred. Yes, we do. We declare that peace is here, right now. Sing it now. Spirit is in this, Spirit is in this place. Sing it nice and loud and clear like you're doing, yeah. Spirit is in this, Spirit is in this place. Get ready to raise that roof. Raise the roof with shouts of praise. Spirit is in this place. Spirit in this place is Spirit. So come just as you are, beautiful, just as you are in your
gosh, you guys sang so beautiful, I cried. Wow, like, is Spirit in this place or what? Well, I'm Valerie Day, and I'm blessed to be your practitioner today, and I'm going to invite Sylvia to bring up our light, and while she's bringing up our light, this week is the beginning of Hanukkah, so we'll bring the light on the door here. Yes, so Sylvia's bringing up our light, and this is just an opportunity for us to pause, have that ritual of bringing forward the light and just feel the light that you are, the light that we are collectively, just opening up to that light. Yes.
Thank you.
Let us say our affirmation together. The circle of love is complete here. This love includes all and is bound by unity. We journey together in that love, hand in hand. We sit in the presence of that love and see the face of God in all. And let us just exhale together as we arrive here, just opening up our service, just invoking the I am that I am, the I am that we are, just standing in that powerful presence of wholeness and oneness and infinite possibility. We know that this service just unfolds with joy and depth and richness and holiness, and the I am expresses in through and as Bobbi, in through and as our musicians, and that the voice and truth falls upon our open hearts and open minds. And we just arrive here today just a little more fully, a little more love, a little more aware. Just giving thanks for our precious community that we get to be together with. And so we know that as we come together today, the world is a brighter and lighter place because we showed up. And so I just give thanks, blessing our time, saying, and so it is, and so I let it be. Amen.
Good morning. My name is Chris Schreiber, proud community member of this evolving and emerging community, and I'm so happy to be with you all here today. Thank you for being with us today, and thank you for being with us out there in the digital sphere. We're happy that you're here. We are a radically inclusive community, and we are here collectively revealing that love is the nature of who we already are. Love is the nature of who we already are. And how do we do that? That's why we come together. So stay tuned, more to come as this unfolds. But let's get some inspiration from some of our guides today. So today as our speaker, we have Reverend Bobbi Becker. Our music team, fabulous music team, led by our music director, Lena. Back in the back, we have our streaming stewards, Matt, John. Thank you for everything that you do. We have our practitioners. You met one earlier, and you saw Sylvia come up with the candle. And we appreciate their support today, so thank you. Hold on, I lost my notes for a minute. And we also want to thank our welcome team. We have Janine, Diane, Ronner, and Lorraine for leading that. Thank you. Youth and family, Wenda is out with the youth and family right now. We'll see them a little bit later.
Yeah, Wenda.
I love it, a fan. We have a Wenda fan. Our production coordinator, Carol Ann, isn't here today, but trust me, no matter where she is holding us in her prayers and in her support. So we thank Carol Ann Perini for her work. And now please welcome up Tori Sina, who's going to lead us in some announcements. Come on up, Tori.
Hi, everyone. I always have to take a look around because you are just beautiful faces on a Sunday. I love it. And if you'd like to join me in our mission, in our vision statement. Through mindful and respectful exploration, we are creating a healthier foundation that supports and engages a whole, beloved community equipped to launch new strategies for a thriving spiritual center. Love it. And my favorite slide of all is that just, you have to chuckle, right? Put a smile on your face. We're gonna go ahead and do some community announcements. First thing is, join Rev. Veronica Silva each month as we examine what it means to practice the most critical agreements we can make with ourselves. It is on Zoom this Wednesday starting at 7 p.m., and we can get the Zoom link through the link in the weekly Waves of Joy newsletter or on our new website, exclamation points. I love it. And there's going to be the Soul Sisters Women's Group. That's the first Saturdays at 10:30 a.m., and that's also on Zoom. And there's going to be a candlelight service Sunday, December 17th at 4:30 p.m., so don't come at 10. And or 11, I guess. 11 is our actual time, right? Followed by a potluck, and no 11 a.m. service that day. And then we also have a winter solstice. We're going to have Vox Angelus, and it looks like they're a vocal alchemical? How do you say that? Thank you. God, I always need you guys' help, and I really appreciate it. So that's going to be Thursday, December 21st at 7 p.m. at Pacific Coast CSL. I cannot say that enough. Next, we have some thank yous. We have thank yous for, ta-da, yes, that is what took place, it looks like. Dale for putting on wheels on the welcome cart. Let's hear that right here. Huge, a huge improvement. Also, Pam, Janice, Janine, Eileen, Carol Ann, Floran, Mike, Christy, Debbie Ann, and Lori, and they decorated this amazing sanctuary. Beautiful. And they also did envelope stuffing for our year-end giving. So that was our thank yous for the thing. And if there's anybody you see out there that have done these things, give them a hug and give them a thank you in person. I think they greatly appreciate that. And I'd like to call up Terry Anderson, and he's going to talk a little bit more about what's coming up.
Hey. Thanks, Joy. Hello, everyone. I'm here to speak about what you may see on your chairs. A flyer regarding Interval House. Interval House is a crisis shelter here in Seal Beach, I believe it's Seal Beach or Long Beach, and that our prior community had donated gifts and money in prior years. We actually had a gift drive where we had an entire room full of gifts. Well, this year we're running a little close to the holiday season, so we're if you could read the flyer, and we invite you to donate to Interval House. We are going to be collecting gift cards next week, and so we will present them to the facility. And so if you decide to donate a gift card, please consider also putting it in an envelope with a holiday card and just express some love with your gift. So we'll be collecting those again next Sunday. If you're not going to be here, or if you just don't want to go out and buy a gift card, if you look at the flyer, you'll see email address for Interval House. You can go online and donate for the holiday to support the women and children who are victims of violence. And so, I thank you very much for coming together.
And this is our call and response sacred song. So I'll sing a line, you repeat after me. We'll do it twice for the chorus, and then I'll do the verse and we'll come back in the chorus. God is love, nice. God is grace. Speak our prayer in this place. We give thanks, we give praise for the blessings of this day. Nice, one more time. God is love. God is grace. Speak our prayer in this place. We give thanks, we give praise for the blessings of this day. For grandparents with loving trust, all who teach and mentor us, for everyone who leads and guides with patient hearts and sad.
speak our prayer in this place. We give thanks, we give praise for the blessings of this day. For a sister and a brother too, friends and family who always see us through. For those that ground, who lead and fold, heart, mind, and soul, that we may grow. God is love, God is grace. Speak our prayer in this place. We give thanks, we give praise for the blessings of this day. One more time. God is love, God is grace. Speak our prayer in this very place. And we give thanks, we give praise for the blessings, for our families, for our friends, for the holidays, for everyone on this day.
Just continuing in the silence for a minute more, just feeling that, letting that God is grace wash over you. We just arrive here a little more fully, a little more completely. Just feeling in to that God is grace. This month we're living from wholeness. Isn't that exciting? We're going to live from wholeness this month. We get to dive together into what wholeness means to us and live from that beautiful place. Today's talk, what is wholeness? I'm sure after Reverend Bobby's done, you will all know clear what wholeness is to you. There is a spark of pure life, wholeness within us all. Within you. We're going to touch it this week and learn how to let it be the reference point for what we do in the world and for how we live our lives. Doesn't that sound awesome? Yes, okay. So when I was thinking about, you know, wholeness, first of all, you know, we as humans, you know, we're all whole. We're all whole, but we get stuck in our head and we make up these stories and we have labels and we forget that we're whole. So when I was pondering this topic of wholeness, I thought, you know, we got to get from our head to our heart. And you know, some people are like, why do you go to church on Sunday? Well, you know what? It helps you remember how to get from your head into your heart. We sing beautiful songs together and we get out of our head where all these stories that we make up that aren't true are operating, telling us that we're not whole. So today, we really want to have that experience of what is wholeness by moving out of our head and into our heart. And when I thought about how do we get out of our head and into our heart, well, that's what we do when we pray. In the first step, for those of you that aren't familiar with our affirmative science of mind prayer, in the first step, we talk about recognizing God, and God is all there is, and there's no place where God is not, right? Well, that's about as whole as you can get, right? Well, so then if we're going to pray and recognize that God is all there is, well, one of our tenets is oneness, right? Well, so if God's all there is, then so am I. We're all one. We're all in that place of oneness. So really, wholeness at its core is really those first two steps of, you know, God is all there is, and I'm one with God, right? But we go out into life and, you know, we see somebody, you know, skinnier than me or cuter than me or smarter than me or has more money than me or whatever freaking story we're making up. They're going on some trip or, you know, all the little things that we judge, that we value, and then we get separate and we forget that we're whole, right? So we come here to church to look at each other and see God in each other and to recognize our own wholeness, right? So that's what we're talking about today. We're talking about the first two steps of prayer. And then in that third step of prayer, what do? We affirm what we want. We don't talk to the bearded dude in the sky and say, oh, please make Mary Jane better. No, we affirm and know that Mary Jane is whole, freaking perfect and complete right here and right now. And we don't like pretend, we don't like maybe kind of know, we get into the absolute, right? What if we're aligning with the I am that I am and the I am that we are. So that's what we're talking about today. And there's just three other points. Bobbi invited me to get up here and speak from my heart. So I'm doing it, Bobbi. She told me to pick three. Let me see how much time we have. Okay, we're good. I don't think we've gone over limit. She told me to pick three bullet points and talk about them. So when I thought about wholeness, first of all, there's three bullet points. There's teamwork, there's trust, and there's truth. Yes, Eileen, I'm channeling your alliterations. Teamwork, trust, and truth. So teamwork, I want to tell you how amazing our practitioner corps is and how they demonstrated wholeness. Somebody in the corps had a human moment, go figure, had a moment of forgetting, of messing up being human, maybe didn't have something on their schedule they were supposed to have on their schedule. Well, guess what? None of you knew about that because the core rallied together. That person showed up and said, oops, I messed up. And this other person showed up and said, oh, I can take care of you. And everybody rallied together and took care. So teamwork is wholeness because we each get to come together as a team and play our parts and do what we're amazing at, right? Like as they demonstrate, as our music team demonstrates every Sunday, teamwork is wholeness, right? And if they're not playing as a team, it doesn't sound very freaking whole, right? You can sit out there as humans and judge like, oh, it was a little But guess what? If they mess up and they're playing from their hearts, you're not out there judging them because they're playing from their hearts, right? So that's teamwork is wholeness. Teamwork is an opportunity for you as human beings having a spiritual experience to experience wholeness. So if you're not involved in a team, get on one here, get on one at work, get on one in the community. Find a team so you can experience wholeness through being on a team. Okay, so the second point is trust. Well, you know what? It takes a lot of trust to be on a team and trust that your teammates are gonna do it as good as you think they should. So you have to, first of all, start with prayer to get out of your own little ego way. Right, because you're thinking they should be doing it a certain way, and that's your stuff, not theirs, right? They're showing up, doing their best. So when it's a team, you gotta extend grace and trust and kindness and love and compassion so you can experience wholeness, right? So truth. I was looking for, Eileen, this one really is you, because I was like, okay, well, I need a T. What is the T word here? Well, the T word is truth, because we get back to the beginning of step one, the I am. Well, the I am is the truth, right? So it's like all of this is on that foundation of our core principle of oneness. So it's truth. It's about truth. So when you forget that you're an amazing freaking whole human being having a spiritual experience, just come back to the truth of the I am that I am, the I am that you are, the I am that we are. So that is my talk on wholeness. And so it is.
Thanks for giving me the out to sound horrible today. I appreciate it, Val. It's beautiful. Great talk. Thank you. To the ones that we got,
Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories, everything you've been through. Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories, memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever, everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody says your name, cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will someday. Hey, everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Hey, everything's gonna be alright, go and raise a glass and say, hey, here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the ones you were here, but you're not. Drinks bring back all the memories, everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today, yeah. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Drinks bring back all the memories, memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Bring back memories, bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, when I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Oh yeah, my heart feels like an ember and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for you, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah, everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Hey, everything's gonna be alright, go and raise a glass and say, hey, everything's gonna be alright, yeah. Everything's gonna be alright, said, everything's gonna be alright, yeah. Everything's gonna be alright, said, everything's gonna be alright, yeah. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Everybody hurts sometimes. Everybody hurts someday. Hey, everything's gonna be alright. Go and raise a glass and say, hey, here's to the ones that we got. Oh, oh. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. So toast to the ones here today, eh, eh. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Drinks bring back all the memories, memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Memories bring back you. Do 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 do, yeah. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Memories bring back you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Memories bring back you.
So, I got to do a little cleanup real quick. Will you give me a moment? Okay. Sometimes I'm a party favor, I think. So, something I forgot to do. See my tree here? I'm going to show you a magic trick, okay? So this tag says, I don't feel feelings, and I'm uncomfortable with feeling. And for those that have a little lemon, could you stand and come forward?
Being vulnerable is weak. It's right or wrong.
I am not, or I have to be perfect.
I am not good enough.
I am alone and will be alone.
I am unworthy. People won't like me if I'm not right.
I don't matter.
The second thing I ask, is the heater on in this room? Because I'm burning up, man. Thank you so much.
And I don't belong.
I don't belong. So what are these?
Lemons.
This is a lemon tree. Why are you laughing? It's a lemon tree. Is it? What is it? It's a pine tree? But I hung lemons on it. Isn't it a lemon tree now? It's all of that. Lemonade tree. I like that too, right? The thing is, all these phrases that were read, these are scripts that play in our mind. And these scripts are the things that I run my life from. And to give grace to the script. Can we give some grace to the script? Right? When I was a child, up until probably my 20s, 30s, I felt I was broken. Literally. Broken. And I was the only one that knew it. And I was sure I was the only one broken. Anyone felt like that before? Yeah. And I thought that the way that I was unable to navigate life was because I was broken. And the broken is, I think I'm a lemon tree. Because there's lemons hanging on it. And that is so powerful to think that because of some of the scripts running in my head that I believe something that isn't true. Valerie, who seriously rocked the house a minute ago, right? Yeah. Amazing. The idea separation is what happens when those scripts are running. They have such power. And I've had scripts. Every one of those read was some script I had. But I imagine that they were scripts that I share with all of you, right? At some point in life, it becomes really, really clear. Now, I think about this book. So how many of you read the book, Are You My Mother? Oh my gosh, I love that book, right? I just read that again this week, just 'cause. And the thing about it is at the beginning, the little baby bird comes out of its egg and there's no one there because mom's off getting food. Doesn't think that the bird's going to be hatched that moment, but that's what happens. So imagine the script that comes out of neglect or abandonment or, you know, not being important. You get that script in your head. So the baby bird goes off and just asks everyone, are you my mother? Because we don't know. We learn from those around us. And it's important, that's what happens in this community, is we give grace to one another because there's that script that plays. And then the mother comes back and says, do you know who I am? And she said to her baby, yes, I know who you are, said the baby bird. You are not a kitten. You are not a hen. You are not a dog. You are not a cow. You are not a boat or a plane or a snort. And the snort was the crane that put the baby bird back in its nest. You are a bird and you are my mother. When the baby bird saw the truth mirrored back, right? Mirrored back. It knew that it was a bird. But that truth has to be mirrored back. To see the face of God. The only way I can see the face of God in myself is if it's mirrored back to me. And it wasn't until it was mirrored back to me that I realized I was not broken. That's what we do. That is the simplest explanation of what we do. Within each one of us is this tree of life. My heart is the soil. This is where I plant things. It anchors the roots of my mind, and my heart nourishes the fruit or seeds it produces. If I do not nourish this tree for what it is, really, then I will continue to think that I'm a lemon tree. And there's nothing wrong with being a lemon tree, unless you're a pine tree. Right? So I think I have to be something that the world is telling me. And so what keeps happening, and here's what's interesting, is these stories start to take away from who I am in life. And it's the same for when I'm with you. My script can take away from who you are. If I think you have to be perfect because I have to be perfect, I can really rock your world in a bad way, right? So it's really important that I understand what the scripts are, and that this place within me, this tree that sits within me, that is the heart, that includes the head, but the head operating on its own, in charge, doing all the thinking, doing all the whatever it does, which it's meant for a beautiful purpose. But at the same time, if that is the one in charge, then what happens is that I run around thinking, I have to be perfect. You have to be perfect. I don't belong. You don't belong. I know that there's right and wrong. I love dying. It's right or wrong. No, it's neither. Because typically on the right or wrong, it's I'm right, you're wrong, or you're right, and I'm wrong, right? Is that right? Our thoughts, these scripts hide our true nature, all those things that we just talked about, they hide our true nature. And what's really important to know is, where do they come from? We don't always have to know the exact story, but we need to know where they come from. And oftentimes, at least, or I should say, in what we teach here, is our thoughts do not create our feelings, by the way. It's the other way around. Our feelings and emotions come from wounds within us. Those create thoughts about what's happening. And we affirm those things by continually repeating those scripts. I have caught myself sitting at home doing something, and this has been my practice lately, where I'm sitting there and a feeling comes up, like just some feeling of kind of icky, right? Just kind of icky. And it's so quick. It's so quick, isn't it? And I'm just like, whoa. What is that about? And then immediately, something about me is wrong. And that's what's really important, is to catch that, to catch when that feeling shows up, and to, because how many of us, me too, get the feeling and you just want to push it away, which means I'm going to get up and I'm going to go do something else, or I'm going to get on my phone and I'm going to go through Instagram, Facebook, podcast, whatever it is, and I'm going to get rid of that feeling. But all I've done is moved it over here, because it keeps coming back, doesn't it? It just keeps coming back. So I thought I would show you this. By the way, I gave this to Chris Schreiber because she loves feelings too. So behind every emotion is a feeling, and behind every feeling is a belief. Do you want me to say that again? Behind every emotion is a feeling, and behind every feeling is a belief. Our body has feelings and emotions. Feelings are the pathway to our script. So emotions are an outward expression. It's what happens outside of us, whereas the feeling is what happens on the inside of us, right? And our feelings are an inner response to a relationship we have with something. It's all about relationship. Recently, somebody said something to me. I was having this deep conversation with someone in the world. We'll call it that, someone in the world. And they said, "Wow, you're very relational." I wasn't sure that was a compliment. And I said, "Yes, I absolutely am. My background is public relations. Of all things for me to go into when I went into the corporate world, I went into public relations, and feelings were nothing of what I was comfortable feeling." But relationships are all about emotions and feelings, or feelings and emotions. And if I'm uncomfortable with those things, then I cannot heal the script, period. I will bypass. I will continue to do, I think, what Jesus, the master teacher, talks about in one of his parables. It's the parable of the sower. That seeds were thrown in different locations. Some fell on a path. The birds picked them up because they were so accessible. And they were easily turned. They were easily discarded. They weren't able to grab root. That's neglect. Neglect. Can't get deep enough into it. The stony ground. Seeds were thrown onto stony ground, which sprung up quickly because the soil's not very deep. Found enough water to come alive, but not enough to stay alive. So when it sprang up quickly, the joy, the sun scorched it, which is when we live in anger. We don't go deep enough. We're not seeing what's really happening. So we go to anger. And by the way, anger is a great emotion. It tells us a lot. But if we live there, it will scorch us. The thorny ground. I think this is my favorite. Thorns choke whatever grows. It grows, the soil's deep, but the thorns come in and they just choke it. This is weeds of anxiety and fear. So what's really important is that we need to look at what we're planting, how we're planting it, and what is in our soil that doesn't allow us to look at our life and those scripts to grow from. We often use the soil and the plant in our movement to talk about the creative process, right? And this soil that we plant in, that is the most important thing. And if we don't look at that soil where everything's been planted and we just keep planting, I'm just going to throw some seeds here and throw some seeds there. If we're not really looking at how we're addressing those things in life, how we're really planting, I can say affirmations until the end of time and nothing will happen if I don't care for them. I have to care for them. One of the things that Ernest Holmes said is, all nature conspires to produce and manifest. Ernest Holmes is the founder of Science of Mind. I have to change his quotes a little bit so they're more relevant to today, but all nature conspires to produce and manifest the freedom of the individual, that it may unloose its own energy. This thing must act in accordance with definite law in the universe, the law which is the universe responds. And the law says that whenever and wherever there is an image, what we hold as true. The image is what we hold as true. That does not contradict the nature of the universe. The image will not only tend to take form, but will take form and will manifest. And it has to be the will of God. And that will be life. Relative to the whole, Valerie talked about what's the bigger truth. And the things that we anchor in that have sustainability in them are things like beauty, truth, and harmony. Everything else will take root shallow, and it will continue to keep us from going into that life that we imagine for ourselves. Now, this tree, I think it needs a little tending, don't you? Right? It's right or wrong. I know that that's not true. What I know is that the world itself and how it manifests in itself is much bigger than that. There is no black and white. The black and white is a place that I put myself that is limiting. So I will work on that. Yes? I don't matter. I may have been neglected in life. I may have not felt that my needs matter. As an adult, this is what I get to do. I speak what I need. I speak what I need. I don't expect you to read my thoughts or think or know what I need. So I will speak what I need. I don't belong. I may have felt, I remember when I was younger, my dad said to me, if I didn't know any better, I'd say you were adopted, except you look like me. That was actually a compliment, by the way. I belong everywhere. When I walk in, I see me in you. So I bring that belonging with me. And if you don't feel like you belong, I invite you to belong with me. That's seeing the face of God. There is not a place I walk into, unless it's not very safe, there isn't a place I walk into that I don't feel like I belong. I am not or have to be, wait, I may have written that wrong. I am not perfect. That's not a good thing. I have to be perfect. That's what I believed. And as long as I believe that, that means that I can't show up really as me. So how do I remedy that? Will you help me? You ask for help. I can't do it all. Will you help me? I am unworthy. I grew up Mormon. This was the biggest thing. Never worthy. The gold ring was always so far out of my reach. And even as a young girl, I thought I was unworthy. Purity codes, a host of things. And so what I had to learn is that my worth is not by following rules. My worth is by what I feel about myself. And the worthy comes from the fact that I'm a child of God. I'm a child of the divine, and that worth is inherent in that. I am alone or will be alone. There's times I feel alone. There's times I feel alone, but I am not alone. I'm not alone because I know that I am connected to everything. And when I forget that, I pause and remember I'm connected to everything. So I go connect. I reach out and connect with someone, the universe, in a conscious way, and it reminds me that I'm not alone. Oh, I don't like to feel feelings. I'm uncomfortable with feelings. Anyone feel that? Yeah. Especially, we'll get that later. Especially if my feelings were ignored or rejected, right? So how do I heal that? I acknowledge my own feelings. I'm feeling this. And if I'm feeling that in relationship, I'm feeling hurt, I'm feeling sad, I'm feeling this, whatever it might be, and I say it and acknowledge it. I don't expect it on you, and you didn't make me sad, I just feel sad. I am not sad, I feel sad. Big difference. And I remember that. I usually use that with overwhelmed. Sometimes this job can be a little overwhelming, right? Okay, what really has to be done? Let's get centered and remember. Oh, I love this one. I have to be right. What a curse, right? There's no right or wrong. Is there one more?
Two more?
Thank you. I am not good enough. Oh, doesn't that just hit you down at your toes? Or I should say all the way to your toes. I'm not good enough. For what? For what? I have to remind myself that I came here to be me, not you. And that's the big thing for me is I came here to be me. No one else, just me. Whatever this pretty little package is, I'm in on the inside. Outside too. But that's the thing. Good enough for what? And I get to ask myself these things. Good enough for what? Thanks, Rob. Oh, you're gonna love this one. Oh. Being vulnerable is weak. Oh my goodness, people. Being vulnerable is weak. Vulnerability is the only way that demonstrates courage. It's courage to be vulnerable. It takes courage to say, I can't do this. It takes courage to say, being vulnerable, that I'm not up to it today. It takes courage to say, I don't know how to do that. It takes courage to say, I don't know. Good point. It takes courage to not be the one that gets the credit. It takes courage to be the one that didn't come up with the idea. It takes courage to not care who came up with the idea. Do you see what I mean? And I get to pick some of those beliefs and change those beliefs, just different, that can support going forward. But also feeling into that. This is one of my favorite quotes. Faith says it's possible while hope says it's possible for me. The point of being in this room, doesn't matter whether you're a practitioner or a minister, any kind of leader, is I'm in the room for me. First. So that I can be there for you. But if I'm not here for me, I cannot do it for you. So I have to know it's possible for me. But I don't have to know it's possible in absolutely every way. I can start, and little by little, when I start and know that it's possible, by not trying to bypass my feelings, by allowing myself to trip, by being okay with not doing it perfect, by allowing my team to support me when, you know, I just wasn't there that day. By just being okay in it. And every time I do that, and this is the key, and by the way, this is mindfulness. The mindfulness is that when I catch myself, you ready? I say it's okay. I say it's okay. Not, gosh, you did it again. Can you imagine if we said that to one another? We'd die tomorrow. As a community, right? But we do that here. So when I catch myself, there's the mindfulness, right? I grab the script, I bring it in. It's okay, Bobby. It's okay you remembered. We'll just let that go. We'll just let that go. And you're okay. Did you feel that? Because that's the thing. Is that we get to figure out these things in a way that allows us to be gentle with ourselves. And being gentle with ourselves means I don't need these. I don't need these. That doesn't mean they're not sitting there where I can see them still. But I know where they're at, right? And I'm not, like, they're not hanging on my pine tree, right? They're not on the pine tree. So, how many of you were here last Sunday? Raise your hand. Okay, most of you. So, when you walked in today, how many of you got a little block? Oh, even better, right? And you got a little slip of paper, right? And you got to, I hope, pick a color. So, did you all pick a word and a color? Yes. From last week, do you all pick a word and a color? Yes. Right? And you know what your word and color was that you picked last week? That you just didn't throw it over here, because you know how that works, right? Right. So, we've given you blocks. So, here's mine. Right? Hold them up. It's like a rainbow. My goodness. And if you need a block, who doesn't have a block? Do you know your color? Okay, Diane's going to walk around and give you a block. So in the back, as soon as we're done today, so if you need to run out, okay, I'm not going to make you feel guilty. Or you can stay for about 15 minutes, all right? And if you can stay for about 15 minutes, there are Sharpies back there. And on that block, you're going to write your word. Okay? And if you want, you can write, put a little flower on it. I am so not, like, this is so not me, like a little flower, you know, little cutie things. I just don't do cutesy. I just don't. But honestly, you know what my word is? Cute is not my word. Cutesy's not it either. But creativity is. Creativity. And being creativity means maybe I got to drop over into cutie every once in a while, right? And I got to kind of anchor into it and see what shows up and what feels right on this. Okay? So there are Sharpies in the back. So afterwards, grab a snack. Please wait till afterwards. Don't go over there and get a pen and grab a snack. It's not even out there yet, right? And get that. Because here's the deal. I also decided to pick a belief that supports my creativity. Crap, I can't read it. Just kidding. That's okay, Bobbi. Curious. I'm going to be curious. But the other thing I'm going to kind of lean into as far as a feeling, are you ready? Awe. Awe. Just feels good to say that. So this fits everywhere. It doesn't look nice, but it fits everywhere. Thank you. I'm just happy to see you, Merrily. Thanks for taking me there. And I picked a quote, which was my homework. Did you pick one? So this is my quote. Perhaps all the dragons in our lives are princesses who are only waiting to see us act just once with beauty and courage. Perhaps everything that frightens us is, in its deepest essence, something helpless that wants our love. There it is for me. So that's what we invite you to do, is to take care of that today. So this year, we're going to keep talking about that through the remainder of the year. So I'm going to give you a blessing. You want a blessing?
Yes.
All right. So knowing that there's only one, remember Valerie spoke to this. There is only one. There's only one, and it is all that there is. It encompasses everything, which means there's no edge There's no center. There's no beginning or end. There is love and joy and beauty and abundance and wisdom. I am one with it. You and 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 you are one with it. Are one with it. And if that's all I spoke, that would be enough. And if I don't feel it yet, then I continue. For I am one with it, because if everything is one, then I am one with it. And I know that everyone in my life is one with it. So this week, as we anchor into that word and see that color in our life, that orange, that yellow, that purple, that blue, that green, that yellow, that white, all those colors will remind me of my friends here. And my color orange, what's your color? Say it out loud. That will remind me everywhere I go that I came here to be what? Orange. Nice. What's the word you picked? What? I can't hear you. What? Thank you so much. We could do this all day. Just knowing that in love, from where we come from, that love anchors and holds all of this. It holds me, it holds you. So I just bless us on our journey as we come into this new year. We freaking got this. Why? Because God's got this. I don't have to do anything but pay attention and step when I am inspired and let go when I judge myself. And give myself grace. And these words I speak for me, I speak here for everyone. And I call it good and very good. And so it is. Amen. Please stand if you are able and sing with us.
I love myself so much that I can love you so much, that you can love you so much, that you can start loving me one more time. I love myself so much that I can love you so much, that you can love you so much, that you can start loving me. Pick it up now. I love myself so much that I can love you so much, that you can love you so much, that you can start loving me a little faster now. I love myself so much that I can love you so much, that you can love you so much, that you can start loving me. Keep it going, yeah. I love myself so much that I can love you so much, that you can love you so much, that you can start loving me regular speed. I love myself so much, so much. That I can love you so much, that you can love you so much, that you can start loving me one more time, last time. I love myself so much that I can love you so much, bring it home, that you can love you so much, that you can start loving me.
Well, was I right? Were we collectively revealing? That was something, wasn't it? I am so grateful to be a part of a community where we get these tangible tools of truth. I'm walking out of here with some tangible tools of truth, things that lead us to our collective healing, our collective wholeness. And yes, I needed the remedial training, so thank you for the handout as a 3 on the Enneagram. I need it. So thank you. Bobbi knows me very well, you can see. So right now, what I'd like to ask you to do as we begin to anchor into this wholeness, nothing says wholeness like circulating the good that we have received here today. Please repeat with me or speak with me our affirmation. I freely and gratefully give from the abundance that is me. We have great capacity for living, loving, and giving. I give today from joy and gratitude. And so it is. There are many ways. I like that. I like that way to give. Right there, I like that. There are so many ways to give. There's a donate button on the newsletter on our beautiful Pacific Coast CSL website. You can text to give. You can use Venmo at Namaste Center for Spiritual Living and PayPal at Seal Beach CSL, SBCSL. So thank you very much, everyone, for your tithes and your donations and your constant giving. And more of this. We want more of this as we share our wholeness and our joy together. And now we get to have the kids come up. Did anybody see the kids back there? Are they ready? We love it when the kids come. We may be cruising past the kids. Okay, I'm going to take a little creative license and jump forward and come back while we're waiting for the kids. Practitioners. Wait, I missed that? Okay, practitioners, would you please stand? If you're a practitioner, would you please stand? These are our wonderful practitioners. This is a great gift that we have here. These practitioners are available to pray with you today. If you want to anchor into that wholeness and that goodness that you heard today, if you have something that's on your heart or your mind that you want to seek some support, these wonderful people are available right over by that prayer happens here sign right after service. Please take advantage of our wonderful service of having the practitioners. You may have received a prayer card when you walked in. If you'd like to complete that and leave that in the basket, these wonderful people will pray for you. And if you'd like to, they'll even send you a copy of the prayer. You too can take it home with you. All right, any children? What are we thinking? Children? No children? They went to get them. Okay, they went to get them. Well, what should we talk about? What should we talk about? Would you like to know about all the notes I took from today? I learned, this is the one I'm really taking with me. I'm taking with me that I learned today that I need to have an inner relationship between the feelings that I have on the inside and the emotions that I express on the outside. So this week, I'm going to be working on my own inner relationship. That's what I'm going to be working on. They're slowly coming. Okay, Terry, did you have something you would like to share?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. I'm trying to fill the gap here. Yay. I forgot to mention, if for Interval House you wish to donate a gift card, please include that most important receipt with the activation code with your gift card.
Logistics yes, are important.
Yeah. So, anyway, thank you. No kids.
Still no kids. Eileen. Oh, I like that one. That's what she said. That's a good one to take home. Does anybody else have something that they want to take home from today? They want to share? Ryan.
I want to say thank you to the church for reinstating the baskets that go around because that makes my life so much easier to be.
Excellent. Thank you. That's right. Let's give that. All right. Let's give them all the teaching some love. That's right. Okay, the children are praying with Reverend Bobbi, so we'll just send them some love. We love our children. We love our children. All right. You know, we kind of need that Reverend to come back, so maybe will we have our assistant minister come and also do this and lead us in this truth, which is a wonderful truth.
The
Yes. All right. I got the hot potato, right? If you are able, will you please stand for our benediction? And thank you, thank you, thank you for being here. Thank you, Reverend Bobbi, for an amazing talk. Yes, indeed. Thank you, thank you. Yes, there's a lot of nuggets to take home from that talk today. I'm going to have to watch it again for sure. Take some notes. All right, so this is a all-inclusive bring your body, mind, and spirit to our benediction here today, okay? And let's do it like as if we've never done it before. So if you're new, that's probably true. And for those who've been here a while, let's just find that newness within us so that we can bring us, close it on out with our benediction. All right, it's called We Are Life. So there's something happening around here. What's going on?
Through me right now.
Yes, yes, it is. Absolutely, absolutely. And what do we call this thing?
It is.
This thing called life.
Yes.
Okay, I've heard about this thing called life, but where is it? Life is in my mind. Life is in my body. Life is all that I am, and life is all that we are.
Yes.
Yes, indeed. So, okay, we got this thing called life. So what do we do with it? I accept it, I am it, and I share it with all. Yes, we do. Here's the good part. Right? Here's the good part. So here comes life. Here comes life, and I'm accepting it. How am I accepting it? Just the way it appears, and just the way it appears not. Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. Feel this down to the bottoms of your feet. Feel the rumbling of life itself traveling up your legs, through your body, all the way to the top of your head and through your arms. You feel it? You feel it? What do we say? Thank you, life. Woo! Yes. Yes, yes. Thank you.
On your feet, see the light in everybody you meet. See now, everybody get up on your feet, see the light in everybody you meet. Yeah, let us be reminded who we've come to be. We are love, we are one, one big family. Hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah. Time from the top, and everybody get up on your feet, see the light in everybody you meet. Everybody get up on your feet, see the light in everybody you meet. Let us be reminded who we've come to be. We are love, we are one, one big family. Let us be reminded. Let us be reminded who we've come to be. We are love, we are one, one big family. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, hey, hey. Yeah, yeah. Have an awesome week, everyone. See you next time.